Hello, welcome back. Corey Braid and Bridesmaid to Be, actresses Wendy Peters and Jane Tancliffe are waiting in the wings to reveal all about tonight's big soap wedding.
First, though, let's find out what the loose women are up to today.
Hello there, it's a very special show today. We're joined by the boys from Westlife who hit number one yesterday. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. Plus, there's a new loose woman in town. Find out who it is at 1:30.
Thank you very much.
Great, look forward to that. Now tonight, Coronation Street will break a world record for the most marriages ever, ever on a TV programme. What a way to do it. It's Les and Cilla's wedding.
What she done to her?
I don't know.
She didn't have it done at my salon.
Pity. Would have bought her a drink.
I love that.
Oh, fantastic. We're joined now by bride-to-be Cilla and Jana's alter ego, actresses Wendy Peters and Jane Tancliffe. Welcome, both of you. What a laugh. That must have
Great
been
stuff.
Such good fun.
It was a hoot,
was.
Wasn't it?
Really funny.
Yeah. We laughed for 2 weeks.
There's no such word as OTT. You can just completely go for it.
Not in Cilla's life.
Sometimes I think we're a Dick Henry sketch, don't we?
Was there a moment where you thought, well, this is the most bizarre moment of my career?
Probably putting my feather boa around status quo. yeah, that was a bit
mine
bizarre.
Goes with status quo. Yeah. I mean, it's you know, fairy tale that I'm in Coronation Street, but then to be stood on a stage in a Legion club singing Rocking All Over the World with status quo.
Happy days, it doesn't get much better than that.
Doing it all that with Rick
Les had a thing, a collar on there,
yes.
As he was standing waiting for his blushing bride. What was
he
all
did.
That about then?
There's something that happens.
Is that tonight then?
Yes, as he goes to check out the Legion Club, something happens right. And he ends up back in his neck brace.
It's been a disaster, hasn't it? The whole lead up to it's been a disaster.
Start to finish.
Monumental proportions.
He's actually not the only one in a neck brace. But we'll leave.
Yes.
Oh, really?
By the
okay.
end of it, there's a few people. Yes. catching.
What about the cake being made of cardboard?
You didn't do very well.
You
making that, did you?
You did
a sailor face.
You did that.
You?
I distracted Diggory Compton, the baker, and unfortunately, it's a display cake from his shop.
I mean,
so
lesson, syllabus lesson. They wouldn't, you know.
Of course,
it's going to be a cake. It's going to sit there for months. It's going to be, you know, unreal.
Exactly.
But no. We cut into it and it just collapses.
Oh, fantastic. Did you two know each other beforehand? Did you work with each other before? Because you look very comfy with each other.
Yeah.
Here and each other.
You know.
All made up for telly.
Yeah.
No, we get on really well.
Yeah. We've actually got, because of course you end up going on the honeymoon together. And we've got the moment here where Les finds out that he's not going.
Oh,
really? Jana! How'd you fancy a fortnight in Magaluf?
Too flaming, what?
You can't take her with you.
We'll pick your passport up, won't we? You'll not need hotels, will you? You can rinse your pants in pool.
Hey, you couldn't pop in Chippy for us tomorrow, could you? Tell them I've gone down with summer.
But...
Oh, and by the way, I want this place spotless when I get back. Or that sham marriage we had will be nearest you get to having me as your wife.
That's him told.
I love that line. You can rinse your pants in pool.
She's got great lines. These two characters are going to Magaluf. Oh, can you imagine what they would get up to there?
It would have been great, wouldn't it, just to see exactly what they got up to.
I'd love them to. You know, sometimes they do little soap bubbles and then do little sort of half-hour little episodes.
Yeah, Jana and Cilla.
It'd have to be
by the army barracks in Magaluf.
One in the morning.
Well, let me tell you, Jana has a lot of fun in Magaluf.
She does. Yeah.
Say no more.
Are we going to see Jana around? She's not going anywhere.
No,
because we've seen little bits of her, you know, but we'd like to see more.
She's
still in the chippy.
Yeah, still in the chippy, and you see us come back from the honeymoon. A couple of weeks' time, don't
right.
you? It's great. It's really funny.
And you can do that look that she has with her mouth.
It's terrifying.
That is the biggest curve.
Everybody comments on that, and I don't know.
It's fantastic. Well, you can't do it if you're smiling.
I can't do it because I'm smiling, but no, it is. Yeah, I don't quite know how it happens, but it just happens.
She does it at home, Kenny.
Well, I was going to say, my husband's probably going over there somewhere, we're going, yeah, I know that face. It happens every day.
And the moments when you're filming, because you said that you've had some 2 weeks off, and that it is intensive for those couple of weeks. Mm. Is it fun or is it? I mean, it's obviously hard work.
Yeah, no, it is good fun. There's such a great team up there. It's you wouldn't think. The pressure we're under to produce so much television, you wouldn't think we'd have such fun, but we do. It really is. I mean, I got sick of wearing that dress. Mm. Yeah. Eight days I had to put that dress
Eight
on.
8 days of that floor.
And it's bad enough when you wear just on the one day. You know, by the end of the night, you can get this skirt off. Yeah. But no, it was 8 days. And my hair, the hair battering my hair took with that hairspray and those kiss curls. Thank you, Jana, for that.
It's Jana's idea.
Yes. 666.
And how are you enjoying it?
I loved it. It's the same thing with Wendy, really. It was a very uncomfortable dress, and I felt like Lily Savage stroke toilet roll holder. So, not very comfortable. But no, it's great. And we've got such a good team up there. We rely on, you know, everybody for makeup.
There you are in your frock and all your glory look, lovely red wedding dress, red bridesmaids dresses. You said Lily Savage. You used to do the Lily Savage show.
Yes.
I remember that.
Two series of Lily Live. Yeah. I was the phone room girl and co-wrote it with Paul as well. Yeah,
you did stand up as well.
I did for 12 years. Yes, and I got to know Peter Kay and Johnny Vegas and people like that, and ended up being in Phoenix Nights and that Peter Kay thing. So it was great. That was my step into acting.
Really. And are you a musical person?
I do. I play the guitar and the ukulele.
Do you really?
Yes. Aww.
Very diverse.
Women of huge talent.
Where is it?
I just happen to have.
Don't do that.
Would you believe? Maybe, perhaps.
Oh, my God! You're so cruel.
I don't know whether it's tuned, and you don't have to.
No, it's not.
Not tuned.
No, well, I won't sing.
We could have got it tuned to start with. Just a little bit of a struggle.
It's not in tune, but...
There's nothing you can do with that, is there?
No, not really. It is a bit... Try and tune it if you want.
Yeah, go on then. Well, you tune
to talk.
We'll carry on.
You carry on.
Yeah. You've got your own wedding coming up, haven't you? Are you engaged at the moment?
Oh, me? Yes, I am.
Well, I'm not. I've been married 12 years.
At the same time.
I'm concentrating on the ukulele. Multitasking. Yeah. Yeah. An actress can't walk and talk at the same time.
Yes.
No, yes, I am. I got engaged 4 weeks ago.
Oh, congratulations.
Mark Bickerton, who is the ex-story editor of Corrie, and created Scylla, he did. So
it's his fault.
Yes, it's his fault. We're in existence because of him, so yeah.
Good gracious. And will you be dressing up?
She should be my bridesmaid.
I should be. If I'm not matron of honour, I'll be very upset. Yeah.
Maybe not in those outfits.
No, I don't think so.
No. I don't think so.
And how was Shirley Bassey last night?
She was amazing.
Was she?
She was just fantastic.
Where did you go and see her?
She was here at the LWT. It's another audience with Shirley Bassey.
Oh, it was an audience with, was it?
Just
no, didn't
unreal.
Get invited to that one.
Oh, dear. No, she was just amazing. I mean, I've always been a huge fan, but to see her live, just the support in her voice. I mean, to have that strength still, it's just, she was fantastic.
Mm. What
she
did
was
she
giving
sing?
It all that. She did all the old Big Spender, Goldfinger, all the ones, and she threw a few new ones in as well.
Yeah.
She was just amazing. Her four frocks, just glittery. She was fantastic.
Good. Well, we'll let you carry on tuning.
Yes.
Don't think you're going to. Have you done it?
Done
oh, okay.
Well.
There you go then.
Very, very good, very classy.
Thank you.
Now, Les and Scylla's wedding, it's the 63rd wedding in Coronation Street. There have been some real classics along the way, though. I'm going to reveal your favourite in just a moment. First, though, Sharon Marshall's here to reminisce. Miss Sharon, look at her frock.
In you can check you with your Halloween dress on.
Really nice. Look at that. And she's got a spider brooch there.
Mm-hmm. It is. We're getting the Halloween costume, but not as scary as your outfits tonight, girls. It is the funniest wedding I've ever seen. I was just watching it, I was crying.
And this wedding is going to put the programme into the Guinness Book of Records. Because this is the one, this is the 63rd, which means that there have been more weddings in Corrie than anywhere else. So what are some of, what is it for you, what are some of the notable ones?
Well, Ken and Deirdre, they got married. So many times, I'm loving their, obviously the first wedding was one of the clips we had, but the second wedding, I was lucky enough to do behind the scenes. It's fantastic. I love the first ever one. Of course, they're doing it live. So it was Jack and Annie's daughter, who was called Joan. And you never actually saw them do the wedding. They could only walk them out of the studio into the car because, of course, they couldn't afford the whole church set and so on. Looking back, remember Mavis and Derek? They both jilted each other and eventually they got back.
Oh, I loved Mavis and Derek.
And Les Battersby wrecked everything for Hayley and Roy because they were going to have a big church do.
And he did.
Wrecked everything. So it's all his fault. And Sunita and Debs, that's why I love the first Asian wedding.
That was brilliant.
It was absolutely beautiful.
That was really good. She looked amazing.
So we should reveal now. Obviously, we threw this wide open to you and said which do you think is your favourite? All right, Sharon, have you got the result there?
I do. It's actually Steve and Karen.
Oh, really?
She'll be really chuffed, won't you? She was out at Soap Awards the other day. She came back for a drink with everyone. But there we go. She's left. It was great though. She was all the fighting
going on.
It was
the whole build-up to that as well as
the second
ceremony.
One, obviously. Yeah. The first one was rubbish. It was just a bet, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Let's have a look. Here you go.
Stephen and Karen have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared the marriage by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of a ring. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder.
Yeah, it's lovely, Karen. And then, of course, Tracy turned up and it's going to drag you out of the chair. Oh, that was brilliant.
That was good. Oh, there's none of that tonight.
You know, considerably different to the one that we're going to see this evening.
I can't wait tonight. That's it. Definitely. Two lots of Cordy.
Thank you, guys, very much.
Thank you. Looking forward to it.
And that was a treat. I didn't think you were going to do it. Well done.
Beautifully done.
Have a gorgeous session afterwards.
Well, there you go. That's your favourite Corrie wedding. Now on to your favourite X Factor people. We've been asking you to vote all morning. It's time for the results now. So, shall I read out the results?
Go and I'll find them.
And you stick them on.
Right, OK.
Right, here we go. So, this has no bearing whatsoever on the programme itself. It's only a bit of fun for us. So, down the bottom, 2% Conway Sisters.
Will I put them down there?
Yeah.
OK.
And then we've got Chennai.
Oh, there's little
3%.
Chennai.
Chico. There. Then we've got Nicholas.
Oh, Nicholas.
Then Brenda. 6%. Maria. 8%.
Maria.
Journey South. 21%.
Oh, Maria doesn't want to stay on.
Maybe
there you
she
go.
Does.
That's all right. There you go, Maria.
And then Journey
South. And then. Yeah. They're all going to fall down. It's all going horribly wrong. Anyway, then there's him. Then there's lovely Andy. And then.
Andy and Shane with 30%. Is at the top.
There. That was beautifully done.
That's excellent. We'll figure out what's gone wrong with that a little bit later. There you go. On tomorrow's show, Fern is cycling the Nile, and so you'll have a look at that. So we'll see you tomorrow. Bye now.
Bye.
And the ITV lunchtime news in just a moment. After that, Westlife with the Loose Women today. That's at 1:30 and at 2:15.